Birmingham. And so I was in Birmingham, he was at Stratford, and I used to have to go and deputise occasionally. His first horn, who I deputised for, was Tiny. Nobody here Tiny. It was about quarter my size, so I spent all my time in the laundry, in the wardrobe, being sewn into costumes, which they'd let out. And then they'd take it all back in again when he came back from being ill or away. And he gave me various great jobs. My best job with Fungi was, I don't know whether any of you saw it, was the Peter Brook Midsummer Night's Dream. There are films of it, and it was a fantastic production. And he sent me to Paris to look after the music. What a gig. So that was great. And we kept in touch for the last, I don't know how many years, 60 years we knew each other. He was my best man, and I'm still married. And so he did a really good job. And sadly, he died earlier this year of Alzheimer's. We used to go and see him, and he was just incredible. He was very gentle and very gracious, and suddenly something would spark him off. I remember last time we saw him, I mentioned Carmen. So he just sat there and started singing, yeah, terrific. And then soon after that, he died. So Guy Woolfenden, the first piece he wrote just after his first granddaughter was born, Sophia, and she was there at the first performance, and which is lovely because we've got a recording of it and you could hear her gurgling in the background. It's got a little bit of calypso in the second and third movement because Sophia's mother was West Indian and Guy fuses calypso with her other things. So here it is. Serenade number one for Sophia.
Thank you. Thank you.